other.
No.
In that case, we'll be playing against Koi the Dragon, and Killstreak will be playing against Diddy Funk.
Alright, so let's get into this match. Here we go. Senior Avery vs. Noble Dub. So he is actually going to be using Ronin. We have seen quite a bit of Shirai Ryu from him.
That's true. Actually, this is the first time that I've ever seen Senior Abram play anything but Shirai Ryu.
Yep. So here we go. But again, Tanya getting her pressure started. This is a bad situation. And Takeda, not necessarily one of the characters with the best armor or the best normals. His fastest normal is down two.
Definitely. And Ronin does have slightly faster armor than the other variations in his sort of sword upswing special move.
Oh, good break. He has Tanya in the corner, but oh, short-lived. And that's going to be the round.
Yeah, it's still going to be really hard for Takeda to get out of that. I mean, his pokes, like you said, are relatively bad. His backdash isn't that great, and his armor is still pretty slow, and yeah. Tanya, of course, known as being the queen
of pressure.
She's
gonna blow it up.
She will. And oh, great anti-air low cannon drill thing. I don't know exactly what to call it. Drill. I remember the name.
Yes,
I knew the name at one point.
100%. And here we go. Nice. Using that string to put Senior Abram back in the corner, but oh, nice spacing from Senior Abram there. Here we go.
Using the pressure. Oh, no,
no.
Drops it. Now, that string, board 1, 2, 2 plus 4, it has a huge whiff time. So if you do that string fully and it misses, you are dead.
Especially with dab. Good presence of mind. Oh, did the delayed wake up and a nice bit of armor from Senior Abram. He's got to do something here.
Nice. Goes for the flip. I like his little mix-ups there.
That bar of meter, though.
Oh, and that's going to be game one pretty quickly. Now, it's interesting to see Senior Abram make the switch to Ronin. Do you think it might have been because of the armor?
It's like, crap, I'm stuck in Rekka pressure. I don't know what to do. On top of that, then she starts mixing it up with teleport cancels, low starters. So, I mean, it's tough.
Yeah, and I mean, especially mixing in that enhanced Kobu throw? Sorry. My names are totally off today, and I don't know why. I apologize for that.
The idea stays.
I mean, she just overwhelms you with all of her pressure options.
Like, yeah, but it looks like Dab actually does know a lot of the strings as well. He's blocking the overhead low strings from Senior Abram, and he doesn't look threatened at all in this matchup.
Yeah, I mean, Abram has just not really gotten out of the corner in either of these games yet.
I mean, he's basically started in the corner. The match starts mid-screen, but he's automatically in that corner. Oh, that would have been an awesome conversion. I like the break, and I like that break.
I agree. Keeping Tanya in the corner is important.
Dab trying to break early to stop the momentum, but Senior Abram, here we go, gets his own pressure going, and this is what I want to see. Let's go.
Once Ronin gets his pressure started, it is very hard to get out of. Almost equally as hard as Tanya's pressure.
Yeah.
I mean, almost everything he does
no.
end in plus.
He just got hit by the raw Rekka.
Very nice. That combo is extremely hard. The fact that Dab hits that every time is really impresses me.
Yep, and it's very difficult for Takeda to punish, especially with his limited normals, and Dab just gets his pressure started all over again.
Ooh, great bait on that armor.
It was desperate, and I gotta say, I agree with it. Abram needed to do something to get out of there.
Very nice just blocking by Dab. Honestly, aside from the fact that he has kind of dominated this with pressure, I think the parts where he's really winning this match are in defense.
Yeah.
I mean, he hasn't let almost any of Abram's pressure get to him.
Not only that, but as soon as he's had the two bars, he's just spent it.
Especially everybody out there, when you see a character that's really good, like Tanya, I mean, we see her almost every week. You know, you can't deny that she's great. It's not a bad thing to pick her. I mean, a lot of people look down on it, but sometimes it's just your play style. And I mean, Dab has done so well with her that I would say she's definitely Dab's play style.
Yes, I agree.
And he's showing it as he's up 2-0 right now, and Abram going back to Shirai
Ryu. I think that's a good choice, simply because maybe he might be a little more comfortable. We've seen him mostly using Shirai Ryu.
Yeah, I mean, I think that...
There we go.
Well, he's used Shirai Ryu the entire season and all of last season, so... The switch to Ronin was weird, and I do like him at least going back to him on the very last game.
See, but if you notice there, Senior Abram was jumping a lot after his pressure to try to bait out some armor from Tanya, but no bite, and wow, we don't really see that.
Yeah, that's
that run cancel off
bait.
That normal.
It is an overhead normally, so generally you try to run cancel it and then do a low, but he just went into more pressure.
Yep. This is looking very bleak.
It is. Senior
Abram. For our Senior Abram.
In that corner. That corner is his home this match.
Yes.
And he needs to go on a vacation if he wants to win.
Nice. Gets himself out of the corners. Oh, here we go. Good confirm.
That is a really cool string. I really like that. It's far range. It's mid. It's safe.
It can end in an overhead or a low.
Yep. who almost gets the whiff punish on the forward too, but it's very hard to whiff punish that move.
Oh, nice try from Senior Abram. Oh, no.
Ooh, goes for the overhead low there. Almost nobody blocks the overhead low, but it is one of her main options.
Oh, rare drop from Dab, but doesn't look like it matters. Senior Abram is respecting Dab a lot right now, and it's causing him to just sit in the corner still. And it's hard. Again, it's hard for Abram. It's not that he's playing poorly.
Yeah, it's just
doesn't really have
pressure.
The buttons either.
It's true. I mean, as great as character loyalists are, sometimes you run into matchups that are just really tough from all of your variations, and that's when you kind of gotta consider your options.
Oh, that could have been a much better punish there. Dab could have won right there.
One more touch should be chip here for Dab.
Ooh, oh, here
nice
we go.
Blocks.
Wow, what a tech.
Oh, well, he almost got a conversion off of that. I've never seen that before.
Senior Abram, still, he's making this comeback. Can he do it?
Oh,
that was
no.
So close. If he would have just hit that neutral jump punch just slightly sooner.
Just barely. That was a really nice almost comeback, though. I mean, I think his Shirai Ryu did better at those. I really love those, especially the recent ones.
He did most of the combat cast except for the DLCs that we did together. And he was a great help. So shout outs to that man. Let's get into the match. It's not about that. That was very risky.
It was.
My goodness.
I mean, that's a huge risk. That's going to put him at a huge advantage
No, it paid off.
Yep, and he used that meter for the first hit.
And this is the classic, if you will, I'd call this the K&M special. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, someone is, except Ketchup never, ever uses summoner.
You're right. Oh, just the tip. So close.
All right, now, Koizu Dragon looks very good at zoning.
Whoa, that was a crazy time to summon Puggles.
It was, just back two into summon?
Oh, good backdash, but you cannot backdash that string.
Yeah, never. Oh, no. Oh, instant neutral jump punch on Wake Up.
And that is going to do it.
Choose Wake Up, assuming he doesn't drop it.
Nope.
All right. Good choice there. Goes for something simple, ends it with the fireball to build a little bit of meter.
Not only that, but just in case Nubkicks did build that last sliver to break, didn't allow him to do it.
Wow, went for enhanced trance to start off the round. Really?
I like that. The only person I've ever seen successfully pull it off in tournament is Michelangelo. Yomi's Michelangelo, I think. Actually, you as well. You two are the best at utilizing full screen trance.
Enhanced trance.
Yeah.
Very underused move, I think.
Yeah, I agree.
All right, now, Nubcake's pushing Koizu Dragon into the corner, and Shinnok actually has really, really good pressure. I mean,
it's pretty good, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's actually very similar to Lao's. It ends in a plus 12 meter burn move, and it's a three-hit string, so.
Oh, here we go, gets caught. Oh, but doesn't convert. His timing on summoning that bat is so tricky.
I know, I've never seen anybody summon bat from point blank so much.
Yeah, and good decision to do health sparks. I like it from Nubcakes. And we're going to tie it up 1-1.
Yeah, Corey almost took that entire round back.
I'm actually excited for this match. This isn't a matchup we've ever seen.
It's the battle to see who controls the Nether Realm.
Yep. And right now, Corey the Dragon still has, in the corner. And again, that's so hard to block. That was low overhead that time. The time before, he did overhead low.
Oh, no. Nubcakes trying to punish, but the bat saves Corey.
Oh.
Wow, that was super unsafe, but Nubcakes not managing to get the punish.
Oh, here we go. Nubcakes finally getting something for himself. Drops the combo, but he's got the corner. Nice tech.
Wow, Wake Up throw by Corey the Dragon.
I don't necessarily like that he put himself out of the corner, though. That was...
I agree. Now he's got so much room to try to catch up to Quan.
Yep. And again, Quan is one of those characters. He has incredible offense. Defense, not so much.
Oh, wow. This could be basically it with Chip.
And that's going to do it.
Oh, wow. What a huge comeback.
Was that an empty jump low?
Yeah, he actually did two empty jump lows in a row, which actually works better with Shinnok than any other character, because Shinnok does have the fastest low starter in the game.
But that's what makes him so awesome.
I know.
He's just like me.
I don't know if Quanti's quite as much of a scumbag as you, but
that's
he tries.
That's
tries.
True. He
and
tries.
And that's what's important.
It's tough, man.
All right, so Nubcakes with the first hit. Going to push Koi Dragon pretty far to the corner already, and that's the one spot that Quan doesn't want to be on this map.
No. Again, limited. In fact, he doesn't have a wake. Let's just be honest. Quan Chi does not have a wake up.
Yeah. The only armor that he does have is that sky drop. And sky drop, there are so many ways to beat it. Did you know you could just neutral jump and it whiffs?
You could not only do that, but you could jab it on the startup. It eats the armor, and then you can NJP before it even comes down to hit you. Yeah. Like, you, there's infinite ways that you can stop that from happening.
Oh, yeah. It basically is not like this. Oh, and no conversion off of Corey right there. That was a big one he needed to get, but he gets another chance.
Yep, here we go. Corey the Dragon.
Oh!
Nutcakes is having none of it. Oh, that was nice. A beautiful telegraph jump in there. I like it.
Yeah, Quan Chi has really good jumping attacks.
He does. Again, he has amazing offense, really good attacks. It's just his defense is, it's just almost non-existent.
Yeah, I mean, he's what some call a glass cannon.
Yes.
I mean,
he is
completely
exactly
one
that.
Way or the other. Wow, Nupcakes runs all the way out of the corner from basically full screen. Really interesting.
Did he
there.
Really run, though? It was more like he floated.
Yeah, he kind of just glided.
Yeah, there we go. That's the word I like.
Death calls for you.
Death calls for you.
Really good pressure here from El Nueva Keiko.
Again, he should not be throwing him out of the corner like that.
I don't
that.
Know why he's doing that either.
No, and especially now he's in the corner, yeah. And Quan Chi's damage in the corner is absolutely insane. He can get over 50% meterless.
Oh my goodness, that's so dirty.
No, and Nupcakes hasn't blocked that shower. Even once.
Oh, wrong rune.
I bet he's going to scoop right here, knowing him.
Don't scoop.
Oh, it's wrong. Wow.
It's not worth the Baskin Robbins, I promise.
Oh, the delayed forward four.
Okay, here we go.
What's the mix-up?
Oh! That overhead was so raw!
It was. That's the scary thing about Shinnok, is he makes you block low 100 times
the
per
entire
match.
Match.
And then he can be like, oh yeah, I'm just going to throw in my one overhead.
I'm
and
just going to
no
throw my heel
that.
On your dome. I mean, he wasn't doing bad by any stretch of the imagination. These matches are 1-1 apiece.
And Nupcakes again taking the early lead. Nice. Down one into Hellsparks. Anything into Hellsparks with Shinnok is terrifying.
Yeah. And that his down four actually combos in to Hellsparks.
Yeah,
which is crazy. Yeah.
And he does have one of the best down fours in the game. It's low profiles extremely
Jails.
Well.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Yeah, that's what I meant.
It's a great down
It's
four.
A true block stream.
Super true. Super annoying.
Super true.
Super true.
Oh, little run under. Little
oh,
fancy.
No combo. That was big. That actually could have been Corey's game pretty much right there, but now he's going to have to get something going.
No, you cannot backdash that. I like that he's trying to, you know, he's being aware of it, but you literally cannot backdash that.
I know. For the record, Quan Chi actually does have one of the best backdashes
in
the game.
He does.
But he still can't backdash that.
Little zoning here now from Corey. I like that he's changing up the pace. That was a huge conversion that he just missed.
Wow, a lot of respect from both players. I've noticed that Corey does block a lot. And, I mean, that's a really good trait to have as a Quan Chi player. You do need to have immense patience.
Oh, and he puts himself in a perfect position. Here we go.
That was really great by Corey. He just sat there, blocked for like 15 seconds, and then made one perfect jump over that.
Oh,
it's going to give
nice
him a huge advantage
conversion
here.
Conversion off that. Here we go, once again in the corner. Oh, and he goes low. Again, his timing on that bat is so nutty.
No, he just does it from point blank.
I like it. It's weird, but usually I'm like, oh, it's kind of unsafe. I don't agree with that, but it's working.
He has literally not been punished for it once. So it works. Oh, no.
Oh, that. Ooh. Is he going to go for another overhead? Nope, just goes for the low.
Yeah, that empty jump low is seriously strong. Nice blocks by Corey.
Such strong. Much wow. Here we go.
Oh, goes to that overhead
again. See, and now the problem is Nupcakes, this is the third time he's just let him out of the corner for free. He's just jumped right out. And again, Quan Chi doesn't have options. Just keep him in block pressure.
Oh, interesting couple, but drops it. Oh, drops another conversion. Drops a third conversion. A fourth
again,
conversion.
What is going on?
Oh, again, not punished. I'm surprised we're not seeing any armor from Nupcakes.
Oh, what a backdash.
This could be it. This should be it purely
so,
on chip alone.
Yep.
Oh, there we go.
Wow. That was so unfortunate for Corey. There was like four instances.
There were actually four in a row. Favorite
Patented
Sub-Zero.
Sub-Zero.
Now, it looks like he's going for Grandmaster this time. He does use Cryomancer also.
Yes, he does.
Ooh.
I think we actually saw Cryomancer from the last time. Oh,
I believe we did.
That was a cheeky little portal summon right there.
Ooh, teabagging in?
I don't think he was actually teabagging. I think he was
a bait.
Doing the motion just to get the skull out.
I think that's possible. Now, yeah. Sorcerer is a variation that we don't see too much. Oh, he is definitely teabagging.
Those are definitely bad.
He is starting this off. Oh, wow. And gets the hit there again.
That could. Oh, beautiful. I like it from Killstreak. You do not want to teabag an online player like Killstreak.
Oh, very nice neutral punch. I cannot believe it beat that jump kick, actually.
I can.
You can. You, sir, are the master. You know all things Mortal Kombat.
That's not true. I've been wrong so many times.
But anyway, we don't see Sorcerer too much. Of course, that is Ketchup's signature variation.
His claim to fame, if you will.
His claim to fame. And for those of you who don't know how this variation plays, he can create portals on the ground. The green one that you're seeing right now gives him one hit of armor that recharges every few seconds. The red one gives him increased chip damage, super increased chip damage. And the purple one drains meter, but you very rarely see that. Now, Diddy Foster really just going for a lot of teabags.
Yeah, it's...
He'd better hope he wins here.
Yeah, because
that's gonna be a blow up.
Oof.
However, this is a very, very tough matchup for Sub-Zero.
This is quite possibly one of the most aggressive Kwans I've seen.
That's true. I mean,
like, he's just running straight at Sub-Zero.
Wow. I mean, I guess it's somewhat a strategy.
Yeah.
Generally, when somebody teabags you, you really want to hit them, you know? But the fact that he's in the armor portal means that aggravating somebody could sort of be an advantage.
Oh, and the fatality?
Wow. I feel like Diddy Foster has some sort of grudge against Killstreak.
Maybe, I don't know, but he ain't no Sonic Fox, that's for sure. Fastest bags in the West still belong to Sonic Fox, even though he's not from the West. Do you know that hammer is a very viable option, and I think this is a good switch.
Plus, I mean, he just gets to take advantage of all of his hits so much more.
Yes.
I mean, Cryomancer does... Wow, T-Bag's even in trance. Wow, what a grudge. But like I was saying, Cryomancer does over 40% for pretty much every hit.
Not trade on the Ice Ball. I mean, it's not going to work because of the armor and the portal there. There we go. And he's going to get a decent at 30%. 33, there we go.
Into the hard knockdown. Oh, that jump punch didn't auto-correct, and that's going to be big.
And that was not a punish. Nice backdash from Killstreak. Oh!
That armor hits again. Oh,
there's
no
a lot of drops from Killstreak, though. I don't like this.
Standing one into overhead hammer. Wow, these overhead hammers are hitting Foster a lot.
Oh, and his own just wake up grab.
They're
just pretty ballsy.
They're just switching around with throws right now. It's like they're dancing. They're ballroom dancing.
Nice. Beautiful use of armor there. I like it. Killstreak. And that was really important because now he also has corner control. And again, Kwan is not the character that has, you know, all the options.
Yeah, I mean, the armor in this variation is great, but the biggest issue is that you have to set it up, and it takes longer to set up than, for instance, summoning a bat in the summoner variation.
Yeah.
So you really need to get that hit for
missing. He's actually been misplacing a lot of his moves, I've noticed.
Great block. Ooh, but very nice pressure by Diddy Foster. Went for the standing one right there,
placing it up. Oh, here we go.
Oh, wow. Still gonna catch him.
I like that he does the extra slide after that, because he is building meter.
Yeah, he builds meter and he switches sides and just kind of confuses you.
Oh, there we go.
Killstreak
says, what about those bags, son? Where you at?
I'm really surprised that he didn't teabag him at all in return.
This is really Killstreak's, he needs to win this.
The stakes are high for him.
Yeah.
And we are going to see a switch to Summoner. Now Summoner is of course the one that we're used to seeing. The bat, we just saw Corey the Dragon playing
that. So here's the thing I don't like about him doing that, is he now gave mid-screen position to Dirty Foster. I don't like that.
I agree. Now there is the opportunity when he does that slide switch setup to slide switch. That works.
Yeah.
To jump back over.
But look at the position he put himself in.
Yep.
There we go. Getting himself out of it. And I've noticed that Kwan isn't even attempting to punish those overheads. Those are not safe.
They are not. Ooh, and this should be basically the kill, including the chip after this.
Yep.
Wow, didn't even need the chip.
Killstreak, let's go. Show this teabagging man what's
round
up.
Two,
yeah, he stopped teabagging. Ooh, nice. He actually goes for that.
He certainly did.
Didn't get a chance to after the switch to Cryomancer. And you know, this is one of the greatest things that you can do as a character loyalist, and that Killstreak's very good at. Killstreak. No, but is the fact that you can learn multiple variations, which is actually also something that we're seeing Diddy Foster use right now.
But I mean, in Diddy Foster's case, it's like,
he still doesn't have armor. Like, he still doesn't have a wake-up.
That's
true. It's just a different offensive playstyle for him.
That's true.
Different setups.
You know, maybe he feels like he can take advantage better of the hits that he gets.
It's working. I'm not going to say it's not.
Yeah, yeah. Final round. But, yeah, we have seen Killstreak switch to Cryomancer a few times before.
Oh, almost got the... That's
the second
time.
Again. You always have to watch that. It's also, it's unsafe. So if he just stood there, blocked it, he could have punished it.
Here we go. Using that beautiful downpour there from Sub-Zero. Oh, but what an NJP. Here we go.
I believe that is Quan Chi's true wake-up. Instant neutral jump punch.
And again, ooh, we're nice. Seeing these bats come out mid-string.
This is almost exactly like Cor the Dragon.
That was actually very tricky. I like the backdash attempt from Killstreak, but that overhead caught him regardless. Oh, here we go.
This should be almost
very
enough
close.
To kill here. Just needs chip.
Yep.
Wow, and that was huge, actually. I mean, basically, Quan Chi controlled that match the entire time, but just a few hits by Cryomancer, and that's a lot of damage.
Yeah, Warlock definitely has the most viable wake-up as far as all of Quan's variations.
Yep. Warlock, which we are unfortunately not seeing, he did go back to Sorcerer, but Warlock has both a 21-frame safe wake-up and an 11-frame unsafe launching wake-up, so really good armor. Ooh, he's gonna push him all the way out of the corner. 1-2-3, a really good option against Quan Chi once he gets into that portal.
Oh, trying to slide to get some momentum. Oh, but he was waiting for it. Beautiful spacing from Diddy Foster.
Oh, drop right there.
Not converting off the 1-1, but again, don't put yourself in the corner.
I know, he needs to slide through him and then jump back over.
I think that's our biggest gripe with all the players we see at ESL is putting yourself in a bad situation.
But I mean, that's a really, really important thing to know in this game. I mean, we see Dab, who is actually the opposite. He is amazing at always keeping them in the corner.
Yep.
He uses that weird Tanya string that puts them behind him and like he uses the drill as an ender, a bunch of weird stuff, throws back in the corner. But, you know, we've seen a lot of that from Nubcakes and a lot of that from Killstreak is not controlling the corner well enough.
So, I mean, Killstreak right there, he's actually trying to just wait out the portal time. Instead of pressuring and possibly getting punished because of the armor, he was kind of waiting. This time he's just going in.
Oh, wow, still doesn't block the overhead. Diddy getting hit by a lot of lows. But actually, his blocks have been pretty good this game.
There we go, Killstreak finally. Nice tech. And
ooh,
here we go. This
that should
actually
be the kill.
Be the round. Yeah.
It's a low hammer or overhead hammer.
Yep.
And there we go.
35%. Good stuff.
Yeah, that damage from Cryomancer is huge. And I mean, he does still have really good mix-ups, good normals, good mobility. Oh, and this is the real big one. Oh, he's not going to have the meter to get more.
Nope, but that's still, I mean, 37% meterless.
Meterless. But great wake-up throw by Diddy Foster.
Good block. Oh, but you can't block forever.
Yep,
it's unfortunate.
But on the bright side, for Killstreak, Rampage is going to be out of meter. He needs to really take advantage of this situation.
Nice blocks. Oh no, but the armor.
Those are actually incredible blocks.
This is going to be very rough. He can't summon a new portal just yet. And this is his chance. Killstreak needs to make something huge happen here. Quan does have one bar meter, but he doesn't have any wake-ups. Is Killstreak gonna end it? No, no! But
no punish! Oh my
brutal?
Goodness. Yes. Oh man, I can't believe that. Except he had,
if Killstreak had blocked there. That was it. That was game.
It was. Round 1. Fight. Ooh, runs right back into the overhead. So he's gonna be able to set up a portal off of this. Now, generally with Quan Chi, with Sorcerer Quan Chi, you try to end in that normal, that 1-4-1, and it gives you more than enough time to set up that portal and get your zoning going, your mix-ups going. Oh, he's gonna be able to. Oh,
here
the
we go. Good
portal
conversion.
Disappeared in the middle of that combo.
Yep.
If you combo Quan Chi
and there's that two
into
hits.
It gives him armor again. So he can actually armor out of your combos midway through, but if he's in the air, you can actually reset the combo on it.
Yep. Which is awesome.
Yep. Two instant neutral jump punches. Very nice throw. Now all he needs is chip.
And he's gonna get it. Yep. I suspect some teabags coming in if Foster's about to win.
I agree. I think we will see them.
Round 2. Fight.
Oh, good spacing there on the slide. Just narrowly avoiding that overhead from Quan and now getting his own pressure started. Oh,
ooh, just barely whiffed right there. Interesting. Diddy Foster not pressing a lot of buttons, but okay, there we go. Finally presses them and gets a huge reward off of them. Ooh, absorbs the ice ball.
Saved him. He should be neutral ducking those.
Yeah,
helping Diddy Foster build way too much meter.
But nice patience. Gonna get some Oki. Oh, and there we go. Baits the throw. This should be enough for a kill.
Yep. Boom. And he has corner position. Now, Diddy does have two bars, but he cannot use those to wake up.
That's
true. He's gonna use those basically for pressure or a breaker.
But one really important thing for Quan Chi, more so than any other character in the game, is knowing the interactables in the corner. And he does have an interactable in this corner. If he meter burns it, that's a very viable armored wake up.
This is a very bad situation right now for Killstreak, though.
Oh. Killstreak blocking very well, but Diddy Foster just keeping it on with the mix-up.
Diddy is completely out of meter right now, though. Oh, and that was huge! Here we go. Killstreak could make the comeback right here. They're both mid-screen.
Oh, ooh, just
wow.
Throws.
That was ballsy.
Goes for the instant neutral jump punch. Very scary. Oh, and this should this be the kill! Be
and that's gonna be it! Killstreak!
Right in the dome. Right in the chrome dome.
Very difficult situation to come back from. And he ended up managing to do it, and he did it with Hat Trick.
Yeah, something that nobody has really seen before. I mean, we see Hat Trick a few times, shout out to like Fluffy Fawn, but
yeah. Fluffy Fawn has a nasty Hat Trick.
He does. But I mean, it's still a relatively unexplored variation. Not unexplored, but under-shown.
Utilized, if
yeah,
you will.
Yeah.
And I mean, we saw some pretty cool stuff, or I saw some pretty cool stuff from Scar earlier when he was botting you in the lobby.
Hey, we don't talk about that.
I saw some pretty sweet combos, I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, no, Scar recently been using a lot of just grenades for control.
Yeah.
Just base control, I really like that. But also we should talk about Hurtful Badger, aka DSV Black.
Yep.
Now, he is not too well known of a player, but he is a Tanya player, as we can see here, I believe from Texas. And this is his first top
eight. So I wonder, do these two know each other then? Because Scar is also from Texas.
It's quite possible. I'm not sure. But I mean, okay, so Hurtful Badger taking the first game pretty solidly.
Ooh, I really like the control here from Scar. Nice overhead to start things up. Oh, and what a combo.
Nice, ends in the safe reload. Now, of course, Demolition, you always have to go for those safe reloads.
Yes.
She only has three grenades, and you're going to want to reload at the end of every combo.
I love the way he's controlling the tempo with those grenades, but Hurtful Badger doing a good job of noticing that as well.
Very nice. Use that armor, and that armor move is really great because
Arcade,
it knocks you so far out of the corner. I mean, that literally took them back to mid-screen.
So he still has one grenade left, and he's trying to zone it, and that's going to do it. Good stuff. Scar.
No pain,
this
no
gentleman
pain.
Has been just Final playing round. Exponentially Fight. Better. I think every week we've seen him.
He has. I mean, he's always been a great player.
Yeah, absolutely. MK9, the best Scarlet, hands down.
Yeah. And, but I mean, yeah, we just haven't seen him do this well until very recently in the game.
That's true. Actually, that's true.
Ooh, hits the very far dive kick. This should be huge damage.
Yeah.
Sonya gets over 40 in the corner.
I mean, as far as the ESL goes.
Yeah.
Scar, yeah.
Nice, just throws out a grenade.
Good patience, good. I like the pacing right now from Scar. He knows what Tanya is capable of, obviously.
Yeah, he's kind of playing like a more mid-range offense game. He's not going crazy on mix-ups, he's not going crazy on risks, just kind of trying to bait Tanya out to move.
And he blocks! He has the meter, but he just chooses to block. I like that decision.
Very nice.
Okay.
He only had one grenade right there, so I think Black maybe was trying to push the advantage.
Sonya
and can't ever forget, she's actually got a projectile.
Even letting her get it started. Fight.
That's true. I mean, one of the best things about Demolition is this way that Scar's playing, when you throw out grenades, it really prevents them from moving in on you. Because you can detonate those grenades at any time. As you see, he detonated it up high in the air right there because he expected Purple Badger to jump.
Good patience there. Scar, again, having three bars of meter, but just choosing to block. That's a huge, hugely admirable trait from a fighting game player.
Ooh,
oh,
interesting.
Nice.
Now, Hurtful Badger, I guess, was trying to just bait some armor right there. He really just stopped his pressure and just let Scar jump out.
Yeah,
that's going
to
hurt.
If you notice, actually, Scar has been using most of his meter to just actually use for breaker.
Oh, no. That was so sick!
That was interesting. At first I thought he dropped that, but it turns out it was a setup.
It just rolled back.
Yeah.
Hit the wall and just rolled right on back.
I've never seen that happen, to be honest. It looked like he threw it way
further. I thought
it
was just going to go off screen.
Yeah, me too. Fight. But still, Hurtful Badger is in a really good position here. Oh no! He really needed to push the advantage there. Scar had no...
Oh, and that a very good wake-up option from Sonya, but good block by Hurtful Badger.
Now, Sonya will have sort of a hard time getting out of this pressure just because her armor is so unsafe.
Oh, but Hurtful Badger just let him out himself. Oh, never mind.
Great anti-air, actually. Tanya does have one of the better down twos in the game.
Yes. But as is Sonya, though. She's a very good down two.
That's true.
As well.
She's got a cool little flash down two where she ducks really low. Wow, Black taking that convincingly.
Yeah, that was almost a completely different set from the first.
Liu Kang's infinite pressure.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, no, but seriously, that is their weakness. So really picking your times to picking your moments to like reload and set that stuff up is a big deal.
I'm gonna throw something out there just because I feel it needs to be addressed. We are not seeing any Johnny Cage.
That's true,
and he has, in my opinion, the best pressure, like almost hands down. You may argue a few characters, but
that is entirely possible. He's got great pressure with his run cancels. Honestly, all of the Cage family have really good pressure.
Yes.
But him in particular. I mean, he is Daddy Cage. But interesting enough, we're just not seeing too many Johnny Cage players. Nice. And again, that's Scar's signature. He's using that move where the drone drops three bombs.
And we are seeing a completely different Scar this game. Now pushing the offensive. He has Tanya in the corner. Slowly letting her out. But here we go, pushing his way back in. Nice from Scar. I like this play a lot.
This should be the kill. Oh, interesting.
Just a little bit of chip. Yep.
Now, I'm surprised that he didn't just throw a grenade on her wake-up. I mean, he could have just thrown a grenade right there. That would have been it. No, I'm just kidding. Of course, we can't actually DQ him for that. But he has hurt our feelings, and I'm crying a little bit
now.
Right
I'm rooting for Scar. To be honest, I was liking his play. He's making smart decisions, good decisions. Now I just want Scar to win.
And he's off to a good start.
What do you think that matchup would be, though? Goro versus Sonya. I don't think it'd be too bad for Goro.
It would be interesting. I mean, especially Demolition. Demolition against Goro would be very strange. He would need to get around the bombs, but I think he could do that with some patience. And then once that happens,
punch walks,
that would be scary. All right, both players choosing the zone. Very different game than last time.
But, you know, Scar has a huge life advantage, and he also has the meter advantage. Not the best decision for Hurtful Badger.
Yep, all three. Oh, wow. Just starts off with Arc Kick.
Actually, one thing we haven't seen at all from Hurtful Badger is EX Tonfa. We have not seen that.
That is true, and that is one of her most important tools.
Especially when you're getting zoned out full screen. I mean, you might as well just throw it out so you can get in and get your pressure started with those Rekkas.
Yeah. But he's using a lot of meter for other things.
Oh, that was
a lot of armor, like we see right there. There we go. Very nice.
That was good.
Meterless wake-up. The only meterless wake-up in the game.
This actually should be it. Right here. Yep.
Nice. Didn't get the brutal for some reason, but that was strong. I mean, all of those games were boom, boom, boom.
Yeah.
And just very one-sided each. But regardless, the play was very good by DSP Black.
That's gross.
That is gross. She's like a fountain.
Sonya wins. Fatality.
Yeah, you're right.
Fight. Unless you were somehow transplanted onto another human being.
On myself?
Alright, so Noble Dab going with Kobujutsu. He pretty much is his only character that he's used. He only used Jax one time this season.
Yeah, he's been all Tanya this entire season, aside from that one match.
Yep. And Killstreak going back to Grandmaster. We did see him with Cryomancer doing really well earlier, but I guess he likes Grandmaster in this matchup.
Oh, and that's a punish. There we go. We haven't seen that punish once tonight, that overhead, but Dab is definitely a player you do not want to test.
Oh, that was amazing.
Oh, my goodness.
He saw that clone come out, and he teleported back. He's like, nope, never mind.
And then he teleported forward and did the empty low.
Tricky.
Tricky gentleman.
But yeah, Dab uses so many of Tanya's tools. He uses a bunch of them that most people just don't use at all.
Oh, very nice.
Killstreak just trying to push Dab to the corner.
Dab is making it so difficult for Killstreak, but here we go.
Oh, and this is maybe going to be the kill.
That's going to be the kill. There is no meter to break.
Wow, very nice choice right
there.
What
a comeback.
Now, actually, that's something that we don't see too much with Sub-Zero in general, was he ended up freezing Dav, but he knew that that combo wouldn't be enough to kill, so he did jump and punch into back 1-2, which is a two-punch string, and that leaves him at so much advantage that he gets a free mix-up.
Yep.
And we very rarely see that, but it worked out super well for Killstreak that last round.
Dav is doing a really good job of telecrafting those clones with the Tonfa.
There it is again. Oh, and great punish. That
there
drill is unsafe. Everything that Tanya does from the air is unsafe.
Yeah. Oh, very that was nice. Tricky stuff.
Oh, but unfortunately, going to throw her out
wow,
of the corner.
That was weird.
I know. I've never seen that happen before. Not quite enough, but...
And armor, yeah. Good decision from Dab there.
Yep. Not a terrible decision from Killstreak either.
No.
Sometimes you just got to risk it.
He was kind of out of options anyway, so...
Yep, and he was sitting on three bars. And one of the most important things about meter management is that once you have full meter, you cannot build more meters. So
yeah.
If you're sitting on it, saving it too much, you're not going to build it back. I mean, you see, he's already built back that entire bar before he got a chance to use it again.
Yeah, losing life, building a bar, I mean, you might as well spend it.
Yep.
Well, I mean, you're not going to x-ray, you know? We rarely see that.
Ooh, and wow, I mean...
Yep.
Okay, there we go. Finally seeing it.
Dav should have known that he was going to burn that bar. Wait a second. This is a huge opportunity for Killstreak.
Ooh, goes for that combo. That combo is very...
Oh, no.
Bummer. But he went for a very hard combo. And the interesting thing about Grandmaster Sub-Zero is his combos are harder on female characters. That's kind of what he does. Anyway, going into the next game.
Whoa,
that actually...
It's like in the pool, a handstand.
Yeah, froze her in the handstand. That was weird. I love all the weird little ways that people
Sub-Zero
get
frozen.
Yeah.
Ooh, nice slide to get under. That is a very good low pro. You know, I noticed about this slide too is it can negate a lot of armor breaking moves because of how low profile it is as well.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it is one of the lowest profiling moves in the game, so it goes under so much stuff. There are a lot of mid projectiles that you can slide under. Ooh, no, if he just let that clone stay there, it might have frozen Dab.
I think Killstreak is getting a little bit ahead of himself here.
And how's he going to get out of the corner?
Yeah.
Just gets chipped.
I mean, at that point, I don't think he should have even spent the bar. He was dead.
Yeah, you know, one thing he could have done is the interactable on the right side on this stage is one where you jump on the wall and then jump out of the corner.
Yeah.
So maybe trying that would work.
Just to get himself out of the corner for the start of the round. But I mean, he got out anyways. Fortunately, I almost want to say he should have teched that because Dav has done that every time to get him back in the corner.
Yep. Dav, he loves that corner control. I seriously can't stress it enough.
Yeah. And again, jump back. Jump back punch. Wow, Dav just stopped hitting buttons there.
Yeah. No, but jump back punch with Tanya is very, very strong. Her jump
extends
too.
Her hitbox so much.
against this guy. He's literally playing too stupid. Like, it's hard. And you're like, I wish he was good so I could play well. You know what I'm saying? Like, there are players out there like that. And it seems like Killstreak, I mean, I haven't seen him play someone that isn't very good. So we've only seen this Killstreak, which is a very solid Killstreak.
Yep, especially when he gets to top 8 here.
Yeah.
I mean, of course, Killstreak, infamous for being the only person to defeat Sonic Fox last season.
Yeah.
And he was able to beat a lot of really good players this season. I mean, he did defeat Crawling Shadow this week to make top 8, who is a really, really dangerous potential
top 8.
Top 8-er.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, he needed the points.
Oh,
got taken away by Killstreak.
Unfortunately, Dab couldn't do anything once that streak started.
Oh,
excuse me, the Rekka started.
It's a Farkle. Oh, can he get the conversion?
Oh,
no,
so
conversion.
Close.
Oh, what a... Interesting. I'm not sure
I
exactly. What
I was gonna say
what
a block, but it looked like he got hit by the low.
I know. I don't know.
What happened.
It looked like the low just pushed him along,
yeah,
and he was
fucking
high.
I wanted to see that again. That was super weird.
But anyway, Dab on match point. But that was really close. Killstreak could have had that if he just punished that low.
Again, we've seen Dab on match point before, but Killstreak has been able to bring it back.
Oh, ooh, just lands into armor. Good choice. Ooh, and that's gonna freeze
up.
You always have to watch out for that on Wake Up. Alright, what's the mix up?
Oh, too early. Ooh, well, I guess not bad bait.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing about that setup, is you can do the overhead even if it whiffs, even if it's blocked. It's normally unsafe, but the clone is still protecting you.
And right now, really great corner control here from Killstreak.
Oh! Hits the hard knockdown, but oh!
That was unfortunate.
It was. He tried to pressure after that neutral jump kick.
But Dab, oh my goodness, Dab. I just want to say, as we see this combo that may kill, yeah, Dab uses the delayed wake up, I think, more than any other player, and he uses it very well.
Yeah, and it's extremely important against Sub-Zero.
Yeah.
Now, this is match point for both players.
This is crazy.
Nice use of armor to get out of the corner by Dab. That's really important.
There we go. Nice pokes here from Killstreak. Oh, and right under the Tonfa. Killstreak is making this very difficult for Dab now.
Now, I wouldn't be surprised if Dab tried to... Ooh,
oh,
there we go.
Here we go.
He used the armor.
It's Dab's turn. Tawny now with the pressure, but Killstreak managing to kind of get out of there.
Nice block. Blocks the overhead.
Oh,
ooh,
Dab,
again.
Good decision.
That armor's working out so well for Dab right now. He's built so much meter.
Oh, no.
Wow, didn't get the conversion, but now all he needs is chip.
All
he needs something crazy here.
Wait a second. Killstreak! Killstreak!
All right, one more mix-up.
Is he going to make this comeback? He has to be careful. Dab has a bar of meter.
Oh,
don't jump yourself
no.
into the corner. Why?
Oh, I think what he was trying to do there was he was trying to bait the wake-up.
He
should have
just neutral jumped.
That's true. That's true.
Oh,
neutral jump would have been really good right there. That's true, but we haven't seen him for quite a while.
We didn't really see him go to locals, yeah, so.
All right, so I think in this matchup, Nubcakes really needs to play defensively and not try to rush in.
Yeah, especially with those grenades. I mean, that's going to control a lot of the screen for him. And the health sparks, I mean, like we just saw there, if Scar is able to place them, or excuse me, space himself properly, his grenades are going to punish almost every time.
Yep. But, you know, the one tool that Shinnok does have that should be really good against grenades is Enhanced Scoop. As soon as she throws them, she can be scooped.
Especially if he's trying to do it at the end of a string to potentially make it safe, that's going to be a punish.
Yeah. Unless Scar does absolute perfectly safe setups, it will be a punish.
Oh, that was
a lot of damage off of a throw.
That was neat.
I like that setup.
And unfortunately, that was a wasted bar for Nubcakes.
It was. Ooh, and this should be the start of pressure. Shinnok, of course, gets the restand every time he hits you. Ooh, but interestingly enough, just
he
decides
wants to put
to go
a full
for zoning.
Screen. He wants the zone. And on paper, I mean, yes, Shinnok has better zoning.
Ooh, nice. Oh, that was a bad break. He wasn't going to get anything off of that.
Oh, no.
All right, still, Sonya has no grenades right now.
This is actually Shinnok's time to go in, but unfortunately, Nubcakes.
Yeah.
Gets
he needed to do a few more Hellspark.
Shinnok in all of his evil glory, you know? It's like, in this, I don't really think we see it.
That's true. I mean, I don't know, maybe the armor helps against these explosions that he's suffering from right now.
I will say I really like the bone stuff that's going on in the back, though.
Yeah, yeah, I like that.
It's the, I think it's just the helmet that throws me off. I don't know. That's just a personal gripe. I apologize.
Fair enough. And, man, Scar just absolutely dominating this pressure. All right, Nebkick's finally getting a turn.
Again, sending Scar full screen.
Wow, just goes for the armor. Very nice. Goes to Hellsparks. All right, here's another full combo. Now, Shinnok does, Bone Shaper Shinnok in particular, does need meter for combos, but he built it so fast.
Yeah. Especially with all the pressure he does put out.
Oh, and oh, not great blocks by Nubcakes, and that should be the kill off of the throw setup. Wow, that's incredible. But man, Nubcakes has actually been getting hit by almost everything.
My favorite part of this stage, real quick to detract from this match, is that guy in the background that just gets killed.
I know, like, he's got a gun, he's fighting these two little baby dogs.
Yeah,
and he's like, oh, puppies. It's dogs! And he's like, ah! And then they actually kill him.
And like, he has a gun, right?
I know.
What? How does he miss that? What is he, a stormtrooper? Like, they're right in front of him. Are you kidding me?
Those dogs, dude, they dogs should be in combat pack.
That is disgusting. 25% for a throw.
I know, it's such a good setup. And he's landed every single time.
And even if you, there's nothing you do, if you tech the throw, you still get hit.
Yep. Oh, and that should be the kill here.
Yeah.
Again, going for that throw.
Nasty.
That is hitting Nubcakes every single time. He really needs to, like, find a way out of that. We'll commentate the matches, and we're just in a room alone, just like, a little think they're doing something. All right, again getting hit by those grenades. Nubcakes is not respecting those at all. All right, no meter here for the conversion.
Oh.
Again, just getting hit by the grenade. This is definitely, I mean, not even so much a lack of matchup knowledge, but a lack of respect here by Nubcakes. Again, literally almost every single raw grenade is hitting Nubcakes. And Scar just really taking advantage of it. All right, here's the corner mix-up. Nice. Goes for the meterless wake-up.
Nice.
That is one of the best options in that situation.
Mm-hmm. It's one of the better options in the game, to be honest.
It is. At the very least, all you do is you roll away and you're safe. The only downside is that you lose grenades.
All right, so Nubcakes is going to break in order to keep momentum, but unfortunately, Scar is going to have none of it.
And again, Nubcakes getting hit by a raw grenade, and honestly, I just don't see him making the comeback here. He's not blocking nearly enough, he's not blocking the grenades, he's not scooping them on reaction. In fact, we haven't seen one enhanced scoop on reaction to anything this entire set.
That's gonna be it. Scar, very convincing in every game. I mean, Nubcakes didn't really get a chance.
Yeah, no, not at all.
I mean, eating 25% for a grab, too. I mean, three times in one round, that was very rough. It has the traps.
Yes, no, now it has traps that are very similar to Sub-Zero Ice Clones, but they don't have too high of a hitbox, and they hit low. So not only are they great for defense.
He's not necessarily crispy with this character,
yeah,
you could say. You know what this is? I think this is just Dab having fun, you know, because he's not really desperate for points. He's making the finals. He's going to be there regardless. So maybe this is him just trying something out, maybe having a little fun, taking the pressure off, playing something other than Tanya for once for me. I don't know.
That's true. But, you know, I mean, the difference between second place and first place is not only do the points matter for seeding,
but money.
But lots of money.
$500.
I know. I mean, if he wants to give it up like that, playing a character he's not familiar with, I'll take it.
But let's be honest, he's really not doing too bad.
He's not, actually. He's doing really great. And just Chip here should be able to take it if he can get that disc out.
The discus. Oh, no disc for you. That was a ballsy but amazing read.
Round 2.
From Scar. Oh, nice. Nice air-to-air there. Put himself in the corner. Now, this is definitely a matchup where Tanya, you have her in the corner, whatever, but you want Predator in the corner, and you do not want to be in the corner against especially Hunter Predator.
Oh, yeah. I mean, that's where he gets his best mix-ups. Ooh, nice. Combos into the EX trap. Now, EX trap on block is plus by itself, actually.
Yes.
He's going to try to push. He's trying to push Scar into the trap. I like that.
Now, the biggest difference between trap and ice clone is that it doesn't go away when Predator blocks something.
No, only on hit.
Yep. So you can do stuff like that.
You know what I actually really want to see from Dab since he got bodied? I want to see Jax. Show me wrestler Jax. If you're really just going to have some fun, show me the Jax. Third in the FGC. Starts with a C.
I have no idea what you're talking about, to be honest.
You do. Collusion?
Collusion, yeah. There we go. I forgot about that word. All right, should here we be go. Big punish. Ooh, no punish. Should have just done forward three. Could have gotten a full combo. Now, Jax is such a scary character. Such good mix-up, such good pressure, great zoning, great everything. And, of course, Wrestler is the variation with the command
actually,
grab.
Did you notice Scar's covert ops?
Yeah, I did notice that, actually. And I think the covert ops may have been a choice for if Dab picked Tanya.
Interesting.
Again, those counters. I mean, her enhanced counter
leads
to a combo of over 40%.
Oh, my goodness. But Scar is just tearing through Dab right now.
Yeah, he is not letting Dab get out of that corner. And, you know, surprisingly enough, Dab not doing any wake-ups. I mean, I believe
that... Oh, my goodness.
Wow, that is like a force punch. Just like, bwong.
Oh, here we go. No, here we don't go.
The drop. Oh, but he gets it again.
I don't understand why wrestler players are ending with the overhead dash punch.
I know.
You get so much more damage off of the grab.
Yeah, and that's the best thing about wrestler is that when you end in command grab, you get great oak. Wow, he just used that knee to just hop over her head.
What is he doing?
I am not sure. All right, chip damage here and just takes the projectile.
That is not the wrestler Dab that I know.
Options. I mean, even if there's
keeping
jumping.
Jax down is very difficult. On top of that, if you have a fast armor breaking move, that dash punch is almost instant.
Yep. So I mean, it's like 10 frames, and it avoids a lot of attacks. All right, so Dab going back to his main.
Oh, sorry, I was asleep. I just woke back up.
But Dab. Looking a lot better here. I mean, I feel like he may just not have warmed up with those characters enough.
To be fair, and I know this, that he has been playing with those characters, but mainly online, he's been playing just with Tanya. Mm-hmm. So he's most comfortable online with Sonya for ESL. Offline, he definitely has those other characters we saw in his pocket.
Yep. Well, so hopefully when he goes to finals, we'll be able to see some other really interesting characters. And
I actually know who he's going to use in the offline finals because he told me. I'm not going to share that here because, I mean, that is his strategy. But I do know who he's going to use offline, and I'm very excited to see that character.
I hope it's Goro.
It is actually Goro.
For sure.
All right. Oh, good bait there, but unfortunately no punish. I mean, that is hard to punish, especially if you neutral jump it.
It is. I mean, that move on whiff is not bad at all.
Yeah.
It's very similar to like Sub-Zero's slide. Like, it takes you out so far that it's really hard
blocking
to punish.
That move is a nightmare. You're going to get punished.
Oh, yeah.
On whiff, it's actually not bad.
All right. Dab needs to make a big comeback here. And oh, no. Okay. It's a good thing he got that throw, because if he had ended that round in the corner, that would have been a big mistake. And interestingly enough, Dab choosing to spend meter here. Ooh, and he could have made huge damage off of that.
You may die now. Oh, that's going to do it. Dab is going to take game number three.
I cannot believe he made that comeback. He used that down forward.
I forgot brutal. About that.
Yeah, but he went underneath that leg flip wake up.
I was going to say more flak than an aeroplane in like, you know, World War II. Or something. I'm sorry. I don't.
You tried. It's okay.
I give up.
It's okay.
If you guys want to fire me, I totally understand.
All right, so Dab can potentially take this whole thing back. I mean, that last game was very convincing. And he's doing well this time, too. But, you know, we do have Scar with his really...
His patented Demolition Sonja.
Well, I was going to say, we've got him having his hat trick Lao.
Oh, where is that Lao?
I know, we haven't seen it yet.
We're not going to see it either because, regardless of what happens now, he's stuck with this character.
That's not true. If Scar loses one more game, it becomes 2-2
not
and
true.
He can switch
not
the hat
true.
Trick. Oh, okay.
That's not true.
I'm sorry. You know what? You create the rules, and I wasn't informed
so
of the change.
I'm so glad you finally understand how it works here.
It's only taken me 6 weeks. No.
It's not bad. It took Brian what, many more.
All right. So Dab just constantly pushing Sonya to the corner. He's just not getting hit by a lot of mixes. Ooh, disrespects the grenade.
That was really, really smart by Scar. He blew it up early.
Yep. Now, there is a mind game there to the grenades. Now, we've talked about it before, but just to recap, she can delay the grenades, and it makes you... It basically makes you want to block, because if she does a fast grenade, you can't get out of it. So jumping, attacking, you'll get blown up for it, literally. And if she does a slow one...
Are you proud of yourself for that one?
Never. But if she does a slow one...
Oh!
It kind of just makes you sit there waiting for the explosion, and then she gets to mix you up while a grenade is on you. So that's the mix-up of her pressure. Both of these characters, they've kind of got a delay system to their pressure.
That was a little late on Dab's part, and Scar getting out of it.
Now, that was good matchup knowledge by Dab. Dab knew that that was not a free reload by Scar. So he just ran all the way full screen and took that punish.
Final round.
And he may not have won that round, but that got him to make Scar waste 2 meters on Breaker.
Oh, my goodness.
Super low teleport into instant neutral jump punch. I can't believe that hit. I can't believe he went for that.
I can't believe it's not butter.
I see through the armor. Ooh, wow. Lucky he jumped there. If you do get hit in out of the air by Sonya's dive kick, she only gets a knockdown.
Oh! The grab does not work because of the armor. What a decision from Dab.
He was really ready for that setup, which is good. I mean, maybe he's been playing Scar, or maybe he's been watching the matches from earlier tonight.
It's very possible. And Scar, though, is going to take it. Dab throwing away the first two games. I don't think he should have lost the Jax one. I think that was just kind of poor play from him, dropping some combos, ending an overhead dash punch when you're a wrestler. Come on, dog. What are you doing? Yeah. But congratulations, Scar absolutely needed those points. This was crucial for him, and he won, and now I think he might be safe.
I'm pretty sure he, no matter what, is going to be
so
at our season finals.
Scar, congratulations early. I might be wrong, but I'm going to go ahead and say you're safe. Make sure you still sign up next week, ESL.GG4/MKXProLeague. Don't forget to sign up for that, but that was incredibly needed for him. Go!
Damn, that hit him so high.
Damn. Yeah, it did. So, congratulations to Scar. Dab just making an appearance just because. I mean, getting some money out of it too. But
Dab also pretty much guaranteeing himself a spot in the finals.
That's 100% guarantee for him now. Dab, we can actually say yes, you are going to the finals. So,
yeah,
I mean, last season.
Huge amount of points. I think he actually might be leading points right now. But I think he. Don't quote me on that. It's him or Sonic Fox.
Yeah. I mean, last season, Dab, like, narrowly, I mean, like, by a smidge. It was heartbreaking. So, this season, to guarantee himself a spot for the finals, which, once again, folks, is January 24th, mkx2.eventbrite.com. Get your tickets.
And again, if you missed the announcement earlier, we are going to have a live combat cast with Derek and Tyler Lansdowne.
Derek Kurtschek.
Ooh. Boom. Sorry.
Nailed it.
You nailed it. Absolutely.
Nailed it. I actually probably did.
But yeah, they will be showing off a Combat Pack 2 character.
Yes, so you guys are going to get early access if you're here. It's part of the Mortal Kombat Festival we have going on. More details, of course, an incredible show match as well. But that's going to do it for week 6. We are going to be on a little bit of a hiatus.
We will.
So we're not going to see you guys for about 3 weeks. Of course, Christmas, New Year's. So everyone have a safe holidays, whatever it is you choose to celebrate. Have a good New Year. And we'll see you next year in January. Have a good one.